The medicinal properties of herbs have long been known to Chinese medical practitioners. Now, a world-class team of researchers is looking to gain insight from this ancient knowledge. Led by Professor Charlie Shui of RMIT University, they are about to undertake a groundbreaking study to find out if the herb ginseng could make a significant difference in the battle against one of Australia's biggest public health concerns, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease.
The challenge for treating COPD is there is no cure from any other current Western medical treatments. What we try to look into that is to look at those patients in earlier stage of COPD using herbal medicine to see whether the herbal medicine improves the lung function and reduce the deterioration.
COPD refers to a range of inflammatory lung diseases, such as chronic asthma, emphysema, and chronic bronchitis, in which the airflow and passages are severely impaired, resulting in the destruction of lung tissue and the reduction of lung capacity.
It is important because Chinese medicine, particularly ginseng, has been used for symptoms like this for many centuries. And whether it has provided a substantial relief statistically, we didn't know because there was no research done, but people continue to use this. And the good thing for ginseng is like there has been much laboratory or we call preclinical work has been done that demonstrate the promise.
COPD affects over 2 million Australians, and it is a major cause of disability, hospital admission and premature death. It is estimated that by 2030, COPD will be the third cause of death in the Western world.
RMIT is a leader in Chinese medicine education and research, particularly in clinical research. So we initiated this project and we invite Melbourne University and Monash University to collaborate on this project. The next stage will be patient recruitment and the trial process. That will involve a number of RMIT staff members as investigators and postgrad students and postdocs. The trial will be actually conducted at the two hospitals at the clinical trial centers, and the patient evaluation, screening, treatment process will involve RMIT staff members and students as well. That will be done at those two hospitals. What we need to look into is any new therapy that can improve the lung function, improve their quality of life, and also to looking into new opportunities for therapeutic developments.